Hello, good evening, and welcome to Whiskey Watch. Whiskey Watch here with me, Terry. We've got a Laphroaig.
A Laphroaig.
Do you know, I can't say me THs and Fs and things like that properly as it is. And me Rs and it. So, kind of Laphroaig. Yeah. And Scottish. They seem to have a mouthful of spit. It's all like, it's nice, I like it, you know, but it's kind of almost Germanic. You know, when you hear Scottish people speaking, I love it, it's all, you know, I love hearing them. But it's like, it's all at the front. Where's mine? It's all at back in. Sorry. Right, Laphroaig. So, if I pronounce that wrong, then, you know, whatever. Just let me know. I'm sure you will. But let me know anyway. Laphroaig. Little, lovely little islandy thing and white sort of distillery and that with the big words woo all across there. Really beautiful looking place on a bay. Right, really nice. And, this is Laphroaig, and this is select, hand selected. I don't know how else you select them with your foot, what, you know. Sorry, hand selected oak casks for perfect balance and flavour. The most richly flavoured of all Scotch whiskies, and established 1815, so quarter past six. This special Laphroaig is created from carefully selected casks of each of our key styles. Ooh. Stretching back in time with one notable addition, the heart of the spirit is drawn from a final maturation in new American oak casks. Oh, probably Kentucky or something like that. Rarely used for Scotch whiskey maturation. I bet that's like Kentucky bourbon casks or something. I don't know, let me know, you know. And bottled in, at natural colour. I like that. None of that E150C and all that crap. Caramel colouring, they call it. It's ammonia caramel, isn't it? You know. natural colour. The result is an exquisite Laphroaig with our trademark Pete Reek, the Koriki. Matched by an additional layer of complexity. And, of course, there's complexity there and spat everywhere. It's not nice, is it? Could you imagine eating opposite me? Why am I peeking in the... Sorry. Complexity and depth brought about by the fusion of maturation styles and different... I was just repeating myself there. But anyway, let's crash away. The old cork in there. Old corky cork. Let's get a bit of glass here. Get a little flame. Whack it down there. Got me water on that ready. Shit, I've got my spoon still in there. That's right, it's only been in there 5 minutes. One thing I like to do is I like to have a sniff of the cork. Kind of, you get, sometimes you get little oils left on there, look. Oh, especially with something like this, dap it behind my neck. Won't turn the missus on, but it'll turn me on. Oh, it's got such a lovely, lovely smell to it. And as it happens, being, not being stupid here, but kind of a good way of getting some of the, especially with something peaty, a good way of getting some of the notes out of it is put a cork on. Right, have a little tip like that and put it on the back of your hand as if you're doing perfume. I know you'll go, what the bloody hell are you on about, Tel? Right, let it kind of drift. Just like, just same as Missy's does when she's out shopping. And you go, oh, what the fuck are you doing? And right, you know, I didn't swear. And have a sniff. Oh. It smells like a mossy peat. You know, like a mossy, grounded peat, like a soft. You know, don't get me wrong, it's a powerful peat, but it's soft and feminine peat, you know, so. It's got a niceness, nice softness to it. It's not like a it's not like a piney sort of attack. Yeah. It's got a strength, but it's got a feminine strength to it. It's got a nice delicate, it's not delicate, it's very phenolic, but it's kind of, I wish I could explain it. It's kind of, it's got a feminine quality to it. In a nice strong way though, you know, a powerful, strong, feminine way. Look at the lovely colour of that. That is such a beauty. That really is. I'm having quite a large one now. Been naughty. Let's crack the lid back on there and put him back up the headphone and get him without knocking the house down. And have a little tap, little tippy tap. Tiny little bit of water out of my little bit. Don't go crazy. All you need to do, don't put it back in there. All you need to do is you, talking irons and things, when you, not the iron like metal, irons coming off of the metal over there. All you need to do is just enough to just separate it. And sometimes if you don't shake it in, you'll see little oils just separating. You can see the colours. Darker at the top, but it's different oils. You see strings, like them strings you get in when you put lime cordial in, saying that all the strings come out different as the kind of different densities are separating out in it. Lovely. Let's just twirl him in a little bit. I don't know if you're getting that. Oh, I love the smell of Lafroy. Strange one, this is the almonds. Slightly different to usual. You've got kind of a slight cigar smoke edge to it. A slight kind of when someone's knocked their pipe out, you know, knocking their proper pipe out, pumping real rough shag and all that business. That little odours you get coming off that, it's kind of sweet but ashy as well, and you know, dark as well. Then you've got little grapefruit edges. Not as much orange as you get in kind of a lot of other whiskies, isn't it? Tiny little orangey, tangerine-y notes, little blood orange notes. You're getting quite a pink grapefruit in there. Zest and piff as well. But very smoky. Kind of very smoky in it. Kind of like you've set fire to an hospital, that sort of idea. It's got that tea tree notes and that in there, and you know, that medicinal note almost off the peat, but smoky as well. I've got to go in there. Sláinte, everyone. Cheers. Let it wet your lips. Especially that thick bit down here, and that's kiss it, you know, let it warm on your lips and that. Jesus, it's fucking gorgeous. Sorry, that is really gorgeous. That is so lovely. God, Jesus, that is lovely. Right, stop keep saying it's lovely and tell you about it. You're getting. As I say, now when I say cigar smoke, I don't mean in a nasty way. See, cigar smoke has got a nastiness and a loveliness to it at the same time. And whether you get that or not, I don't know. I don't smoke myself. I don't like smoking it. But you get that sort of, yeah, I could have that. That's quite nice. But then you get, ugh, what's that all about? Both together, you got a bit of that. Oh, man, that's good. Nice little kind of oaky edges in that. Dry, quite dry oak. Dry oak edges. little burnt edges, as if you've got a new cask and you've burnt it a little bit, kind of burnt it in and out. Those little toasty sort of burnt barbecue almost notes. Nice little vanilla edges. It's really, really gorgeous. Look at the legs on that, look. Long and wide. Long and wide open. Just how I like legs. It's on the whiskey, I mean. Yeah. That is really gorgeous. Absolutely fantastic. Well, what will I say? Bum, 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 bum. Try it, buy it, and love it. I said try it, buy it, buy it, try it even. Buy it, try it, and love it. That's lovely. See you in the next one. Don't be late, because I will start without you. Bye.